I think what we should do. Mark?
Yes?
What do you think?
Well, who's going to go first? This one? I'll flip you for it.
I hate you, you guys. Listen, I
think... You got green on your shoes.
I thought we should... Okay, you and me need to go and have a shower.
I'll flip you for it.
I wonder what that smell was.
No, but if we're in the shower, would you do some... Because, you know...
Sure.
Would you do some of that Paul Revere in the rain?
I was thinking of it.
Just help him on my shoes, okay? Take three more of the pink ones and sit down.
Taller than Billy.
Actually,
everybody's taller than Billy.
Possible.
I think they're all winners. Sing.
Good thing, baby. Sing. Good thing, baby.
You can sing along with me.
And when you opened the magazine, there was a staple right in your nose there.
No, it wasn't in my nose. But it could have been.
Yeah, I'm glad I didn't kiss it.
I
could almost taste it.
So, and if you turn on the television, I spy, maybe. And if you ever really paid audience anyway. I said my thank yous, and oh, I know what it is.
I taught you English to my own.
And I before the show. Is that where she got knocked up?
1965 I was born.
So, it is true, but it was strange. I mean, I thought he was a wonderful man, of course, a lovely man, and an incredible guitar player and talent. But the kids were there, you know, to see the monkeys, of course.
He was a good dad as well, Micky.
He was good. Yeah, that's true. But it was kind of strange. In fact, you guys... This is the honest to God's truth. This is what it was like, Jimi Hendrix opening the monkeys. Everybody putting on this show. I want to say hi to my wife here and all of no, not you, sir. That's my wife. And my good buddy Jim Kerr! Jim Kerr! What are you up doing so late? Or what are you late doing so up? Oh, that's right. You don't have to be at work until morning. Okay, I'm gonna do this tune for you. I've written by Mr. Neil Diamond, but before I do it, I gotta ask you, any little kids out there in the audience? Yeah, there's a couple. Oh, there's one guy. I just want you to know, I sang this song long before Shrek.
I can get his pain.
off beat.
Whatever it's called this week. You know that place. place that used to be Westbury, where the stage turns round. It's just like the 60s, only you think, am I doing acid or is this stage moving? Closer and closer to Waterbrand. And normally when we play here, like Herman Shermich play here, all you get to see is every 5 minutes you get a good look at my drummer's arse. And tonight, my drummer's arse is hidden from everybody. Say hello to Dave Ferrara, the best drummer. Being with these two teen idols here, Bean Idols, whatever you want to call them, I realise that for once, I am still the youngest of these actors.
In your dreams.
You'll always be the youngest.
I'm with you.
Yeah. And I noticed that I am the youngest, but I'm also the fattest. I mean, Micky will tell you, I'm not holding anything in, am I? Walking around stage with Micky Dolenz. And Mark, seen anybody kick their legs that high? Come on, own up. John Cleese, you're right, John Cleese. Anyway, I once said it, this is not fat, this is, everyone knows, this is actually my arse. It's all the way around.
It's a bit high, isn't it?
It starts off when you're around 40, and you're laughing now, but when you hit the big 40, you'll notice an inch of arse will be sticking over the top of your throat. Yeah. Micky tucks his in every morning.
That's not my ass.
The other inch he tucks in, yeah.
Got that from the elephant.
Yeah. Of course, there's people here tonight who've moved their... Significant difference. They're laughing back. Thank you, Micky. These are my, all my records too. Let's do just a little bit better with this.
But you love yours better.
I don't
blame you.
No, I'd swap. But I haven't done any of my shit once, like, as I said, I only top tens. I like to do a song, you know, Micky did all those songs that were written for him. I wrote them aside. I said, this is a number one. So I said, I've written another one, it's a number two. I'll have dated one of them just to get them to listen to the song.
Yeah.
I know she has a dad who did that achy breaky. Love achy breaky.
Don't do it.
Say that one for me.
I listen to David Johnson. I can do Herman really well. Can I be on the telly in America?
I listened to all your songs when I was a kid.
Kelly, we've been doing the end of the movie.
I love your phrasing.
Thank you. I just stole a bit here and a bit there, but that didn't stop the Bee Gees, did it?
No, it didn't.
For a bloody concert. Oh no, Mom, not them again. You ever heard of Herman Chubbins? How old are you? You heard of the Monkees, right? How about Paul Revere and the Raiders?
Not a clue.
Do you have a computer at home? What's your name? Okay, would you do me a favor, copy that for all your friends and don't worry about it, we want to be famous. Share it in the oh, it's been fabulous. Who likes that? The grandma is from Westbury. Now, as Davey says in his show, it's now called Mrs. Brown, you've got a lovely walk. He does it every night. On the 5 days a year that he works. He doesn't need to work. We like to do the Connie and Harvey, Mrs. Brown, you've got a lovely daughter. Then we're going to segue straight into Rock and Roll High School. We're so pretty vacant. Look at the look on Mickey's face now. We're so pretty vacant. Isn't that the Sex Pistols? Yes. We're going to do it tonight.
Come good as it ends.
M-I-Y.
this section for you, Mark. Let's see if it's still alive anyway.
Brady, it's not in tights. You can't do it.